Lipids are one of the four major classes of biomolecules. Lipids may be defined as biological molecules that have very little solubility in water, but are soluble in organic solvents. Lipids are an important source of energy for cells, they form the basis for biological membranes, and they can be membrane cofactors or signaling molecules. In this video, I will talk about the chemical structures of several classes of lipids. If you see the structure of a lipid molecule, you should be able to sort it into one of the six categories mentioned in this video. The first class of lipids I'm going to talk about are fatty acids. Fatty acids have hydrocarbon chains that end in a carboxylic acid group. The hydrocarbon chains are usually linear, not branched, and usually contain an even number of carbon atoms. They can vary in length, typically having between 4 and 24 carbons. Now the fatty acid shown here has 18 carbons. If the hydrocarbon chain has no double bonds, it is called saturated, meaning you can't fit any more hydrogen atoms on the chain. If it has one double bond, it's called monounsaturated. The first carbon-carbon double bond added to fatty acids is usually added between carbons 9 and 10, counting from the carboxylic acid end. Double bonds in fatty acids are almost always cis and not trans. Because there is no rotation around double bonds, a cis double bond forms a bend or a kink in the chain, like this. Fatty acids with two or more double bonds are called polyunsaturated. Additional double bonds are typically added at every third carbon, as shown. Although chemists count the carbons in a fatty acid from the carboxylic acid end, in nutrition literature, the carbons are often counted from the methyl or CH3 end. This terminal carbon can be referred to as the omega carbon, and a fatty acid with a double bond, three carbons from the end, such as the one shown here, is referred to as an omega-3 fatty acid. Fatty acids are sources of energy and are structural components of more complicated lipids. Glycerol is a three-carbon molecule with three hydroxyl groups, as shown. Fatty acids can be joined to these hydroxyl groups via ester linkages. The resulting molecule is called a triacyl glycerol, also called a triglyceride. The fatty acids in a triacyl glycerol can be of different lengths and degrees of unsaturation. Triacyl glycerols are used to store fatty acids as energy reserves in adipocytes, or fat cells. If one of the acyl groups of a triacyl glycerol is replaced by a phosphate group, the result is a glycerophospholipid. The phosphate group itself can be modified with different polar or hydrophilic groups, such as choline or serine. A few different glycerophospholipids are shown here. Notice that they all have polar or hydrophilic head groups, shown in red, and hydrophobic tail groups, shown in blue. In this diagram, the letter R represents the long hydrophobic chains from the fatty acyl parts of the molecule. Now, if part of a molecule is hydrophilic and another part is hydrophobic, the molecule is called amphipathic. Their amphipathic nature makes glycerophospholipids ideal molecules to form the basis of biological membranes, as I'll show in another video. Another class of amphipathic lipid is based on the molecule sphingosine, shown here. Notice that sphingosine itself has a long hydrophobic hydrocarbon chain. The nitrogen of sphingosine can be modified by a fatty acyl chain via an amide linkage to give a ceramide. A ceramide has two hydrophobic hydrocarbon chains. When this OH group of a ceramide is modified with a polar head group such as phosphocholine, the result is a sphingomyelin. Note that the head groups can contain carbohydrates, in which case you would call the lipid a glycolipid. Sphingomyelins are amphipathic and, like glycerophospholipids, are found in membranes. The fifth class of lipids I want to mention are steroids. Steroids are characterized by a system of four connected rings, three with six carbons and one with five. Many steroids, such as testosterone and estradiol, are hormones, but cholesterol is a component of membranes. Some lipids don't fit into the structural categories previously mentioned, but are still lipids because they are predominantly hydrophobic and not very soluble in water. For the purposes of this course, if the structure of a lipid doesn't match one of the first five types I described, then it goes in this last sort of miscellaneous other lipids category. I've chosen two of many possible examples to show here. In the next video, I'll talk about the properties of bilayers formed by amphipathic lipids.